Yes.
Wow. For me?
Yes, for you. From giving life.
Thank you.
It is hard to believe that this woman is the same person seen crying in this video. However, the video tells the truth. The first time we visited her, she was living a very difficult life, constantly in tears due to the emotional wounds she had suffered. Her pain was profound and unbearable for anyone to endure.
Winfred KARAMBU.
My name is Winfred KARAMBU, though many people know me as Mama Kinsley. The last time you visited me, I was overwhelmed with tears because life was very difficult. However, through prayer and faith in God, He has worked miracles in my life. Today, I can testify to the wonderful things He has done for me.
Winfred is the eldest of four children. She was born and raised in a place called Meru. Throughout her childhood, she faced health issues, including an illness that caused paralysis. However, with treatment, she began to recover and eventually regained her strength. After finishing high school, Winfred started seeking a livelihood as she couldn't continue her studies at university. She began working by buying secondhand clothes and reselling them. During this time, she met the father of her child, who was also involved in the same line of work.
We fell in love and started our life together as a couple. In 2020, I became pregnant. When I told him the news, things began to change. I saw a different side of him that I had never seen before. As soon as I told him about the pregnancy, he asked me if I would consider an abortion. I told him that I would not do that. I would keep the baby and give birth to our child.
After this, she realized that the man did not love her. Life became very difficult as both her husband and his family began to treat her with hatred. At that point, she decided to return to her father's house, and she was pregnant at the time. A few weeks later, she gave birth to a beautiful baby boy, but her troubles were far from over.
I felt that he had decided to break up with me forever. When our child was 2 months old, his father started calling me frequently, saying he wanted to visit the baby. I told him it was fine, and he could come. When he arrived, he seemed happy and mentioned that the child resembled him. By this time, I had rented a small house to live in with my baby. I had also made an agreement with my husband, in front of his parents, that he would help me raise our child because he eventually accepted the child. However, it didn't take long for him to break our agreement. After a while, I asked him why he hadn't followed through. He told me he was coming to see me and wanted to discuss something. That evening, when he arrived, I went to pick him up because he didn't know where we had moved. When we got home, I asked if I could make him something to eat, but he said he was fine since it was already late. We went to bed immediately. In the morning, he asked me to go to the market to buy some meat. I asked him why he wanted meat so early in the morning instead of milk. In my mind, I thought he might be hungry since he hadn't eaten the previous night.
As a mother who had left her child with his father, she initially felt no concern. She made her way to the market, but her heart was uneasy. She felt a sense of worry that she couldn't quite explain. She hurried through her errands and returned home as quickly as possible. Upon arriving, she witnessed something that shattered her heart, something she would never be able to forget for the rest of her life.
His eyes were wide open and his tongue was completely out. When I asked him what had happened to my child, he replied that the child was sleeping. I told him, no, this child is not sleeping. I approached and checked if his heart was beating, but sadly, he was not breathing. My husband immediately took the child and suggested we see a doctor. He placed the baby on my back, but since the body was numb, I held him to my chest. At the hospital, the doctor confirmed that the child had died a while back. My husband went to the reception and told me to take the child to the morgue. I put him on the bed tried breastfeeding and begged him to wake up, but it was all in vain. During all this, my husband took all the phones to prevent me from calling my parents. Later, I got my phone back and informed my parents about the child's death. They came to meet my husband's parents to understand the situation and then returned home. My parents advised me to go back to the hospital and explain everything, including how my husband sent me to the market and how I returned to find my child dead. Authorities tested the child, and the doctor confirmed he had died from suffocation. My husband was immediately arrested. I had to pay all the bills to have my child buried properly.
At this time, Winnie felt like she was carrying the weight of the world on her shoulders. She had no one to help her, and the hospital debts were high. Her child needed to be buried, and her husband was sent to prison. Fortunately, she managed to get help to bury her child. However, her suffering didn't end there. She began to live a painful life, often picking up a baby toy and staying close to where her child used to play. She couldn't sleep without medication, and poverty became a constant struggle for her. This is how we found her. When we saw this, we knew we had to take action. We published her story on Afrimax, and charities from around the world donated through givinglife.com. Thanks to your generosity, we were able to return today to see her again with what you provided. We were amazed at how much her life had changed compared to when we first met her. Publishing her story has helped her in many ways.
Yes. After that, I received phone calls from many different people, all coming to support me. God bless them all and fulfill their desires. This is what I want to tell them. What helped me the most was surrendering all my problems to God. It made a difference because, as you can see, I am happy again and able to laugh. I didn't try to fall in love again because love is not easy and it takes time. For me, I needed to be very careful to avoid making the same mistake as before.
Her life has changed significantly. She is now able to live happily again and looks much better. At home, she is capable of doing everything, unlike before when she was always in tears and isolated. During our conversation, she still didn't know the main reason why we came back to see her. Here's what happened after she received the help you provided.
So you've seen that today I'm on a different t-shirt.
Yeah, I remember Giving Life.
I have a surprise for you.
Okay.
People who donated little from Giving Life to Makwako wanted to open here and see what is there. From here to Anne. Yes.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
For me? Yes, for you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for me.
My economy.
Thank you so much, guys. I'm out of ones. I was about to talk in this, but what I'll say is that whoever stretched their hands to donate, to give me this. May God bless them. I don't know what to say. Mungu tu awabariki. It's coming from my heart. May God bless them.
This money will help me expand my small business, and I thank everyone who contributed. I can't find the right words to express my gratitude, but God bless you all. May God fulfill your desires. That's what I can say now. Lastly, I want to share that I am now a singer. If you want to support me, you can find me on social media. My accounts on TikTok and YouTube are under the name Mama Kinsley.
We thank everyone who contributed to the world. Afrimax has a message. Never lose hope, no matter how hard life gets. There are people out there who care and are willing to help. This shows that compassion and generosity can truly change lives. Thank you for watching. I am Simon Greenwood, and this is Afrimax English. Don't forget to subscribe.